Welcome to this week's episode of Ask Your Excel Question. In the previous video, we learned how to build this annual calendar in Excel. In this video, we're going to follow up with the same calendar and learn how we can highlight the specific dates on the calendar, whether it is holidays or weekends or other event types. You can color them differently using conditional formula. That's what we're going to learn in this video. Now let's get started. Okay, so we are going to continue from where we left off in the previous week. We had a calendar built. All I have done now is added three groups of dates. So this is the list of holidays, this is the list of work events, and this is the list of personal events. And you can have any number of such event dates, groups, or types, and then you can name it however you would like. I'm just naming it as holidays, work events, and personal events. And you can prefer to, you can choose to rename it differently as well. And the dates are in this format. So make sure that you're putting the dates in the correct format so that Excel can recognize it as date. And then the last thing is put them in a table. So this is a table. As you can see, when I select it, I can see that this table is named as T_HOLS. But again, you can name it however you prefer. But the more important thing here is that this is a table, and this is a separate table, this is a separate table. That just makes the formulas work much better. So make sure that you put them in. The first step is to create your list of event dates and put them in separate tables. So that's step number one. Now in step number two, we're going to write the conditional formatting formula to color them on the calendar. So let's begin with writing the first conditional formatting rule for weekends, and then we will write the rules for these event types. Before you go to the conditional formatting, let's start with the select the cell B5, because this is the first of the calendar date. So go to B5, just select it, then go to conditional formatting, hit new rule, use a formula to determine which cells to format, click inside this area, and then write your formula equals weekday B5. And again, B5, because we are starting the calendar dates in B5, I've put B5, I'm typing it in, comma, actually just close parenthesis, equals 1. So 1, in this case, the weekday function, it will return 1 if it's a Sunday. So for example, if I leave it like this and I say format the font to be this red color, okay, and click OK, nothing happened. So we'll go back to conditional formatting, manage rule, so that we find the rule that we applied. And remember that we only applied it to the one cell because that was the only cell selected. But we want it to be applied to all the cells. So I'm going to select all of the 42 cells in each month. Once you select one area of cells, to select the next area of cells, keep pressing the control key. So while I'm doing this, I'm continuously pressing the control key, and that's why I'm able to select multiple groups of cells or multiple ranges of cells together. The other thing you have to be very watchful here is that some months may have only 5 weeks, some may have 6. You may want to make sure that always you're selecting all the 6 weeks in each month. So 6 weeks and then 7 weekdays. So it's like 42 cells in each month. This is important because maybe you'll want to use the calendar next year and then it may have, you know, 6 weeks in a month. So this is what you do. Now you have selected everything, hit apply. And now you will see, hit okay, and let's go up a little bit. Now you see that all the Sundays are colored in red font, and this is because we put a formula to say weekend weekday equals 1. So let's go back to manage rules again, and if you want to do, for example, Saturday and Sunday, so 1 represents Sunday, 7 represents Saturday. So in order to do multiple days as weekends, in this case I'm going to just do or open parenthesis, I can just copy this whole thing, comma, and then instead of 1, I'm going to say 7, close. So what this formula is doing is take the weekday of the date. If it is 1 or 7, then color it in red font. So 1 or 7 is Sunday or Saturday. I'm going to hit OK. Apply. There you go. So all the Saturdays and Sundays are now colored in red font. So this is how simply you can highlight the weekends on your calendar. So this was our step 2 to apply the conditional formatting rule for weekends. Now let's move on to the step 3. We're going to do new rule, use a formula. And this time our formula is going to be a little bit different because we are going to use these tables, right? So let's do holidays next. So equals match B5, comma. Now you're going to select the dates in this table. Then do comma 0. Because we want an exact match of date, I'm going to do 0. And then I do greater than 0. So what this formula is doing is take your date in B5 and then compare with the list of dates in this range. And if it, and then we're doing an exact match, so we put a comma 0. And then if there is an exact match, then the match function will result in the row number. And that will be a positive number. And we are comparing that number with greater than 0. So if it is true, then it's a holiday. If it's not true, it was not a holiday. So I'm going to use the fill color, for example. Let me use this blue. And I'm going to hit OK. You can also change the font if you want at the same time by putting a white font or so. I'm just going to just do the fill color. And I'm going to hit OK. And now an important thing here is that we need to check what it is applying it to. The formatting rule is going to apply this format to all these cells, but we only have B5 selected. So I'm going to go to the next rule, the weekend rule. And then I'm going to copy the whole thing. Make sure you copy the whole thing. Come back here, remove what's already there, and then paste again what you copied, and then hit apply. So now you will hit OK to see the beginning. And now you'll see the dates are colored, the holidays are shown on the calendar. I'm going to go back to manage rule and then show you how you can also change the font to be white. Hit OK, hit apply, and now you see the holidays are in blue fill, white font. Okay, now we're going to repeat the same thing for 2 more for the work events and personal events. The formula is going to be very similar. I'm going to do match B5. And in all these cases, you want to make sure that you have selected B5 when you're doing these conditional formatting rules. Otherwise, you will get different results. So make sure you're selecting B5 and then do all these conditional formatting rules. So now I'm going to go to the work events, select everything, comma 0, greater than 0. So if this is true, then I'm going to choose the fill to be gray. And then I can do the font to be white. Hit OK. And now again, I need to copy all the cells because I want this rule to be applied to all the dates on the calendar, not just to B5. So I'm going to hit apply. There you go. All the work events are now highlighted in gray. One more time, we will do it for personal events. Match B5, comma. I'm going to select all these dates. And comma 0, greater than 0, format, fill, do a green, and you can do a white font, and then hit OK. And then make sure that you select all the cells, and then paste it here, apply, there we go. Hit OK. So now we're done with creating all these 3 types of events, and the weekends are done now. So you can check again the personal event. For example, 3rd February is a personal event, so it's green. 1st February is a work event, so it's 1. Here it is in gray. And then holidays, let's say 4th May. So let's go to May. 4th May, however, it is highlighted in gray. So what is happening here? So 4th May happens to be in a holiday, and also it is a work event day. So there is an overlap. And then similarly, 12th January, there is a work event, but there is also a personal event. So it is highlighted in green, not gray. So the last part of this tutorial is, how do you handle when there is overlap between multiple dates, right? So we're going to go and check the conditional formatting rules again. You will notice that the order here, so the green comes first. So if an event or if a date has a work event and a personal event, the personal event will be the first one that is selected. So what I'm going to do now is to, let's say if I move it down, so keep watching the 12th January. Right now it is a personal event, but you can also see that there is a work event. So if I move the personal event rule below and hit apply, now the 12th January becomes a work event. So this is how you can control the order in which the colors are applied. If a date is overlapped between two events, so you can choose your own hierarchy. If you want your work events to override the personal, then you will do gray over green, and then otherwise you'll do the other way. Same thing with holidays. If you don't want the holidays, if you want the holiday to override everything, then you will move it up. So now let's watch the 4th May here. It's currently marked as a work event, but if it is a holiday, then hit apply. And now the blue or the holidays takes the overriding order or the top priority, so it becomes a holiday on the calendar. So this is how you can control the order. And as I mentioned earlier, you can create any number of such event groups or types. And then for each event type, you will apply a new rule using the match function formula that we went through. And then the last part here is the weekends are always in red. As you can see, we're not applying a background fill, so it is only the font color. So if, for example, you kind of move it up, now what happens is, let's hit apply. So when there is a personal event on March 9th, it happens to be on a Saturday. So if you want the red font color to indicate it's a weekend, you will make sure that the weekend rule is above. But if you want, if you don't want that to be shown with the red font, then you will move it down. And then now hit apply. And now the font color for weekend is not shown if there is a conflicting event that happens. So let me recap what we did in this tutorial. So we started with a blank calendar, just a calendar without any colors. And we created these three tables, which are the list of holidays and then two types of events. You can have more like this. Next step, we created a rule for weekends using a simple user formula option, and we used a weekday function, and then we wrote a simple formula to highlight all the weekends in red font. Next, we wrote another formula in a conditional formatting rule, and that is to highlight all the holidays. And here we are using the match function, and then we return greater than zero. It's a event, otherwise it's not an event. And then we repeated the same for two more types of events, like the work events and personal events. And finally, we saw how you can control the order of these rules if you have conflicting events on the same date on the calendar. If you have any questions about any of these that we covered in this video, please post them in the comments. And if you have any suggestions for topics to be covered in the next video, please do so as well. I look forward to your feedback, and I'll see you all in the next week's episode of Ask Your Excel Question. Thank you very much for watching.